Thanks for joining me. My name is Trevor Spring. I'm the Vice President of Supply Chain for Focus Brands. Focus Brands develops global multi-channel food service brands. Our brands include Auntie Anne's Pretzels, Carvel Ice Cream, Cinnabon, Jamba, McAllister's Deli, Moe's Southwest Grill, and Schlotzky's. With a network of over 6,000 locations and thousands of suppliers globally, it is critical that we deploy the right technology to leverage our scale to benefit our customers. Today, I'm going to share what I've learned during my foundry journey that helped me gain internal alignment and executive approval to invest in and commit resources to my vision of a connected company. Historically, this has been a daunting task, as organizations have different systems, data structures, and processes that are not designed to work together seamlessly. Fortunately, technology exists to make the vision of a connected company a reality. The challenge we all face is getting everyone to buy in, commit the resources, and do the work. The first step is to gain alignment on the business objective, and most importantly, how it will benefit the customer. It is this last point about benefiting the customer that resonates with the C-suite and will unlock the game-changing opportunities in front of us. Now, I'll get into my foundry journey and what I learned about building consensus for technology adoption. We started with a single problem. Our restaurants needed to receive the products they ordered from suppliers more consistently. We have a small team to monitor inventory of thousands of items delivered each day. We needed to leverage technology to scale our ability to monitor and action on all supply risks. Prior to deploying Foundry, we were reactive. We were using limited tools. In Foundry, we developed and deployed what we call the Inventory Alert Inbox. Now, we are proactively monitoring inventory across our network and all delivery events. The application surfaces rule-based alerts in an inbox-like format and gives our analysts the ability to provide direction to our partners at scale with the click of a button. As a result, our franchisees will more consistently receive product from their suppliers so they can focus on their teams and their guests. In less than 60 days of deploying Foundry, we achieved the results that we expected. Since then, we've built a half dozen more applications, and we have a multi-year roadmap outlined to continue to scale the value of Foundry. The journey to get where we are now was a long and winding road. I learned a lot along the way, and my hope is hearing my journey will help you on yours. I pitched technology solutions to my executive team without success for a number of reasons that can be summarized as my failure to communicate how the solution would benefit the customer. I knew the solution benefited the customer, but I hadn't framed it in that way. Instead, I explained how it would make my team more efficient, and that was it. It's this shift from internal benefits to customer benefits that led our executive team to make the investment. Nothing is more powerful to an executive than the words of the customer. It is essential to speak from the customer perspective for the message to resonate with the executive. Here is an example of what this looks like. Our customers are our franchisees, the people that actually operate our restaurants. One major pain point is when they order from their supplier and they don't get what they order, they cannot serve their guests with excellence because they don't have the products that they need. This means they must either disappoint the guest or they must leave the restaurant to source products themselves. This wastes their time and their money. Additionally, there's a direct correlation with guest satisfaction and getting what they intended to order. Guest satisfaction also correlates with return visits and sales. It is this description of the problem that resonated with our customers, my stakeholders, and our executive team. Prior to that, I was shouting from the mountaintops how much we needed end-to-end visibility and sophisticated forecasting models so that we could improve fill rates. But that just didn't connect. Here is a step-by-step guide to developing your own internal pitch. Step one, talk to your customers and document their pain points. Be sure to include what it would mean for them if you could remove their pain points. Step two, summarize the pain points into themes with specific examples using real data. These themes will help you keep your pitch clear and simple. Step three, connect the dots. How does removing customer pain points add value to your organization? To help with this, you're going to develop financial models and use cases to illustrate how the dots connect. Step four, build consensus with the internal stakeholders, one by one. To identify the key executives and stakeholders, you need to understand their KPIs and who their customers are. Then work backwards to connect their pain points to the solution you're proposing. It is critical your stakeholders understand how their interests align with the solution you're proposing. Step 5, summarize the entire business case and the process you followed. Make sure to tell a story. To do this, start with what you heard from the customers, using their words. Show how the dots connect from the voice of the customer to your stakeholders' interests to your solution. Outline the impact to your stakeholders' KPIs. Step 6, pitch with confidence and ask for the investment. You need to sell the solution and come prepared with timelines. For example, by Q3, we could increase X by Y if we deployed Foundry by Q1. I'd like to take you through the pitch we put together. We started by interviewing our customers and key stakeholders to develop user stories. This will help to ground everyone in what problem we are working to solve. It's important to outline pain points and what it would mean if they were to be removed. Now that your audience is grounded in the problem we're solving for the customer, outline the high-level value drivers to help your audience connect how your solution addresses the pain point themes we discussed earlier. Next, be sure to connect your solution with other initiatives in your organization so that your audience understands how it fits into your bigger picture. Boil everything down to a single core decision. Would you invest X to get Y in Z years? Or, if you can improve W by X in Y for Z investment, would you do it? State your business objective and develop a simplified thesis or mantra that encapsulates your pitch. For example, clean data plus better technology equals better decisions and cost savings. Illustrate the value using real data. Make sure to use an example that will resonate with your audience. Put together the financial model that shows the ROI, including all components of your solution, including the headcount. Build a simplified timeline that is quickly consumable. I recommend avoiding too much detail and keeping it high level. There will always be objections, and it's important to listen to the objection and acknowledge it. Don't be defensive. Remember, you're solving together. Understand the reason behind the objection and empathize. If people feel like you understand where they're coming from, they will work with you. Respond with a solution that addresses the objection and provides value. And last, confirm the objection as resolved and ask for permission to move forward. I'd like to give you some key takeaways. First, connect your proposal back to your customer's value. Build consensus with all stakeholders and create an army of supporters. Start with one problem and prove the value. Don't stop there. Work through problems one by one and follow this process iteratively. Lastly, I'd encourage you to think even bigger because Foundry can handle it. It's been my pleasure speaking to you. I hope you got something useful that you can take home with you to build the consensus you need to drive your initiative and take your organization to the next level.